Iowa and Nevada just closed at 10 o'clock, the last of those key battleground states in this election. To help us break down the numbers that we're getting in so far, we turn to 11 News reporter Jayne Miller, who's joined by former Congressman and NAACP President Kweisi Mfume. So the big question for you guys right now, both of these candidates have mathematically mapped out several different paths to 270 electoral votes. Do we have any idea yet which of those routes is looking to be the most viable?
Kweisi, that's the question. Is at this point, this is a very tight race in the presidential race. How do you see this going over the next hour?
Well, Pennsylvania's in and New Hampshire's in, so the president has got two holes, states that he really needed to hold. I think the real issue is Florida right now. Until that something comes in there, we're not going to know definitively. But, you know, it's closer than the president thought it would be, and yet he's still trailing more than he wanted to in Virginia. So I think it's going to be another 30, 40 minutes.
You know, I stood with you 4 years ago on a night that obviously was historic. There was such energy and excitement around the Obama campaign in 2008, that just hasn't seemed to be the case this time around. What happened?
Well, I think more than anything else, people kind of assumed that he would just get reelected. And I think as we got closer and closer to this election and they were reading the poll numbers and the tea leaves, people realized, I've got to turn out. I've got to recreate and re-energize the enthusiasm that I had. And that's why I think we're seeing the large turnout. But I think people kind of laid back initially thinking that Mitt Romney was not the challenger that he ended up being.
You, when you say Florida, I mean, voters are going to shudder to the thought of 2000 and the Bush versus Gore. Do you foresee perhaps that kind of night?
Well, I hope not. And if it is, I hope it doesn't go to the Supreme Court for a decision. You know, states have the ability to control their elections. That's part of the Constitution. And so we hope that Florida has improved. I'm just hoping that there's a sort of expansion now in the numbers that we see. And if we don't, then that could, in fact, be the case. You've got provisional ballots, you've got absentee ballots, and this thing right now is separated, I think, by less than 300 votes.
Kweisi, I wanted to talk about Maryland for a moment in terms of turnout. We saw long lines this morning. That subsided as the day went on. There was a great interest in early voting, with about 430,000 people in Maryland that voted early. In 2008, the turnout was about 78%. Again, a lot of enthusiasm. This time around, what we're hearing, you know, kind of a significant drop-off in turnout. What do you attribute that to?
You know, I'm surprised. I would have thought it would have been a higher turnout.
With these ballot
questions. The ballot issue.
Right.
I mean, I thought that that was driving it. I haven't seen any real turnout numbers yet. I'm hoping that maybe these were preliminary. We will see that we got up to about 80% in terms of turnout. If we didn't, I'd be surprised. I mean, the ballot issues alone were a reason for people to turn out and vote. And every time I went past a polling place, there were lines.
One certainly drew a lot of money with over $90 million. Actually, $96 million between the two of them.
Absolutely. I should own a TV station. I could have made some money.
There you go. All right. Kweisi Mfume, thank you very much. Kate, back to you.